Hello children, good morning children. Today I am going to start new chapter 7, sound. Before knowing the sound, we must remember or we must learn vibratory motion or oscillatory motion, to and fro motion or back and forth motion or up and down motion of a body is called vibratory motion or oscillatory motion. There are some examples of vibratory motion or oscillatory motion. Motion of pendulum. You have seen pendulum, and motion of pendulum is oscillatory motion. Motion of swing. Motion of a stressed rubber. Motion of a stressed string. Motion of membrane of tabla, etc. The vibration of a string, membrane, stretched rubber, swing, pendulum, all are vibratory motion or oscillatory motion. Sound. Sound is a form of energy. Sound is a form of energy which gives sensation of hearing in our ears. So, our ears is responsible to hear sound. So sound is a form of energy which gives sensation of hearing in our sound, in our ears. Sound is a longitudinal wave. Sound is a longitudinal wave. Sound cannot travel in vacuum. Sound cannot travel in vacuum. Sound needs material medium, solid, liquids or gas, any solid, liquid or gas, for its propagation or traveling. A speed of sound in air is 330 meter per second. In water is 1450 meter per second, and in steel is 5100 meter per second. So a speed of sound in different material are different. A speed of sound in different material are different. Sound is produced by repeated vibration of the particle of the medium. Sound is produced by repeated vibration. Repeated vibration of the particle of the medium. Pendulum. First pendulum. So when pendulum is pushed and is released, it starts vibrating and producing sound. Faint sound. When pendulum is pushed aside and is released, it starts vibrating to and fro. That is, oscillatory motion is started or vibratory motion is started, so it produces sound. A stretched string of guitar. A stretched string or wire of guitar. When wire is plugged, then it start vibrating and producing sound. So vibration must be done, then sound is produced. Membrane of drum. Membrane of drum. When drum is beaten, membrane starts vibrating. Membrane starts vibrating and producing sound. Tuning fork and rubber pad. When tuning fork is striked on rubber pad, it starts vibrating and producing sound. Vibration of air column. When air column start vibrating in windpipe like flute, then sound is produced. So sound is produced when vibration started. When vibration started, sound is produced. Characteristics of sound. Characteristics of sound. There are five characteristics which describe completely the sound wave. How many characteristics? Five characteristics. There are five characteristics which describe completely the sound wave. First, amplitude. Second, wavelength. Third, time period. Fourth, frequency. And five, velocity. So see the wave. This is the waveform. This is the wave form. This is amplitude. This is amplitude. This is amplitude. And this is wavelength. This is wavelength lambda. This is wavelength lambda. So one complete vibration is A, B, C, D, E. A to E is the one complete oscillation. Second one, E, F, G, G, H, I. So one oscillation from E to I. A to E, E to I. Second oscillation. So you will discuss about five factors: amplitude, wavelength, time period, frequency, and velocity. Amplitude. The maximum displacement of a particle of the medium on either side of its mean position of the vibrating body is called amplitude of the wave. It is denoted by A. So this is the maximum displacement from mean position P, Q, mean position Q, and maximum displacement A. So the maximum displacement of a particle of the medium on either side, this side or this side, on either side of its mean position of the vibrating body is called amplitude of the wave. It is denoted by a small a, and its SI unit is meter. Second, time period. The time taken by a particle of a medium to complete its one vibration is called the time period of wave. So time period, so A, B, C, D, E. So from A to E, time is taken, and this time is known as time period of a wave. Time period of a wave. It is denoted by capital letter T. It is denoted by capital letter T, and SI unit of time period is second. Next, frequency. The number of vibration made by a particle of a medium in 1 second is called frequency of wave. It is denoted by F. It is denoted by F, capital, sorry, a small f, or a small n, or mu. So this is F or n or mu. Frequency. and frequency is reciprocal of time period. And frequency is reciprocal of time period. Frequency is reciprocal of time period. Thus, the SI unit of frequency is per second or hertz. Next, wavelength. Wavelength, the distance traveled by wave in one period of vibration of the particle of the medium is called its wavelength. Wavelength is denoted by lambda. Wavelength is denoted by lambda, and SI unit of wavelength is meter. Or we say that this is crest. So distance between two successive crest, this is trough. So distance between two successive crest is also known as wavelength, and SI unit of wavelength is meter. Wave velocity, the distance traveled by wave in 1 second. The distance traveled by wave in 1 second is called wave velocity. Wave velocity is denoted by V, and SI unit of wave velocity is meter per second. Wave velocity is equal to wavelength upon time. Wavelength upon time. So V is equal to lambda by T. Wavelength is equal to lambda by T. So it is clear. Amplitude, wavelength, time period, frequency, and velocity.